राष्ट्रीय पराशक्ति विद्यालय CBSE क्लास फोर्थ सब्जेक्ट साइंस।
गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक टू फोर्थ साइंस ऑनलाइन क्लास। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्टेड ए न्यू लेसन, दैट इज 12th लेसन, एयर वाटर एंड वेदर। दैट लेसन वी लर्नड वेदर एंड देन सन्स रोल, दैट इज रोटेशन एंड रेवोल्यूशन एंड इट कॉसेस रेन ऑल्सो। Okay, in today's class we are going to learn more about air. Okay. Air is all around us. It is a mixture of several gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. It also contains water vapor and dust. Our earth is surrounded by a blanket of air is called the atmosphere. The blanket of air is called the atmosphere. We cannot see the air, but we can feel air when it blows. The moving air is called wind. A gentle wind is called breeze. Then a strong wind is called gale. And the very strong wind is called storms. Storms that occur along with thunder and lightning are called thunderstorm. Wind affects the weather of a place. Next, sea breeze and land breeze. In coastal areas, the wind blows from the sea to the land during the day. This is called the sea breeze. The wind blows from the sea to the land during the day is called sea breeze. During the night, the wind blows from the land to the sea. This is called the land breeze. Then sea and land breeze occur because of the sun. During the day, the land gets heated up more than the water in the sea. The air above the land is warmer, it rises. Cool air from above the sea blows to take its place. Thus, the sea breeze blows during the day. At night, the reverse process takes place. The land cools down faster than the wind water in the sea. So, the water is warmer than the land. The warm air above the water rises up. The cool air over the land rushes into it, take its place. Thus, the land breeze blows during the night. Next, more about water. More than 70% of the earth's surface is covered with water. Water exists in nature as snow, liquid water, and water vapor. These states are interchangeable. First, an evaporation. The heat of the sun changes water into water vapor by a process called evaporation. The heat of the sun changes water into water vapor by a process called evaporation. Take some water in a glass bowl, place it in the sun. Observe it after a few hours or at in the evening. Has the amount of water in the bowl gone down? Where did the water go? Yes, this is because the heat of the sun has evaporated some water. When the weather is very hot, more water gets evaporated and so water vapor content in the air increases. This makes the weather humid. Next, condensation. Take some water in a pan and cover it with a lid. Ask an adult to heat it gently for about 5 minutes over a fire. Okay, now ask the adult to hold a steel plate over the pan. Okay, can you see the drops of water forming on the plate? Yes, the water vapor cools down when it comes in contact with the cool plate and changes back to water. This process is called condensation. The water vapors changes into water when it comes in contact with cold air. This process is called condensation. Clouds are formed when water vapor condenses into tiny water droplets. The bigger water droplets fall as rain. On cold winter mornings, we see droplets of water on grass and leaves. This is called dew. These droplets are formed by the condensation of water vapor in the air. Next, water cycle. In nature, the process of evaporation and condensation takes place continuously. The water evaporates from lakes, rivers, oceans, and other water bodies. It then condenses and falls down as rain and snow, and then goes back to the same lakes, rivers, and oceans. This forms the water cycle. This process happens again and again. The repeated change of water to water vapor and then back to water is called the water cycle. See the picture. First, the underground water. They are the sources of water, lakes, rivers, oceans, and other water bodies. From these water evaporates by the heat of the sun to form clouds. The water vapor condenses around tiny dust particles in the air to form tiny droplets of water. The millions and millions of these droplets together form clouds. These small water droplets join together and become bigger and heavier. When they become very heavy, they fall to the ground as rain. Then this water evaporates again and falls as rain. This process happens again and again. Next, purification of water. We should drink only clean water. The dirty water can make us fall ill. Water from taps can be dirty and impure. Thus, water used for drinking and cooking needs to be purified. We can do it in the following ways. They are boiling, sedimentation, decantation, filtration, and chlorination. First one, boiling. Boiling is the process to kill the germs found in water by heating. Boiling is the simplest way to kill the germs found in water. The boiled water should be stored in clean and covered pots or bottles. Next, sedimentation and decantation. Sedimentation and decantation is the another method of purifying water. This process in which the insoluble impurities settle down is called sedimentation. The process by which the insoluble impurities settle down is called sedimentation. Then the process by which water is gently poured out after sedimentation is called decantation. The process by which the insoluble impurities settle down is called sedimentation. The process by which water is gently poured out after sedimentation is called decantation. The decanted water may still have a lot of impurities. The decanted water may still have a lot of impurities. Then go for filtration. Filtration is a better process than sedimentation and decantation to purify water. The process in which water is cleaned by passing it through a filter paper is called filtration. Then last one, chlorination. Chlorination is a process in which chlorine is added to kill germs in dirty water. Chlorine is a gas that kills germs. These days, chlorine tablets are also easily available. Chlorine is a special substance added to kill germs. Clean water is precious. It should not be wasted. Then uses of water. Water is useful to us in many ways. Can you say in what are the ways the water is useful for us? Yes, we need water for drinking, cooking, bathing, growing plants, washing and swimming, and some transport purposes, and for obtaining energy such as electrical energy, that is hydro energy. We need water for drinking, cooking, washing, bathing and swimming, etc. Okay, this lesson is over. Do the book exercise, page number 140. First one, moving air. Answer, wind. Moving air is called wind. Then zebras. Zebras blows on day. So the answer is day, A. Then water vapor changing to water by the process of condensation. Then filtration by using filter paper. The fifth one, chlorination used to kill germs. So 2, 5, 1, 4, 3. Okay. The book exercise will be discussed in the next class. Thank you.